So I'm opening up the floor to any questions. Any questions? Any questions? Any questions?
Which is 65 theatres on my wall. No.
Can I accept one?
Tell you what, no, let's put it this way. I've got 9 neighbours who are within 35 metres of that planet.
But the estate is not a pensioner's estate.
It's going to make it a lot busier. And if that doesn't get done, I don't know what's going to happen.
Well, bringing families in,
we
need things for the kids.
That's not evidence. I can give you that.
Is evidence on the floor if you want.
I can give you that off my front door. As they say, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink.
I've been there 3 years. I've been here
66 years. And we've always played on the dolly heap.
Yes.
Always.
Yes.
I'm just an ordinary resident at Southfield Gardens, and what I'd like to ask myself is, since the shortage of a lot of residents, normal residents, who haven't got any affiliations to boards, associations, councils or whatever, why do you think that is? You've got very, very few people here in attendance from a population. Why? There's a lot of things I would like to ask on the open forum. The first one is, why are there so few residents?
Well, it's a difficult one.
It's not difficult. Well, make it more interesting to people like their audiences. Get the bulky public in here. You're not going to get answers of people who've got affiliations. What you want is your public here who are residents.
We have town council meeting every month, which is open to public question time. That is advertised. Every month, the only month that there isn't a town council meeting is in August. There are at any time, public are welcome at any time, and we are open to questions.
How come the interest cannot be generated to attract the public to
attend? Well, as they say, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make a drink. We make these things available for people to attend. Lack of interest.
I think the answer. Sorry.
Do you mind that, Chairman? Because I didn't finish on the same question as this gentleman's asking. My name is Bob George, by the way, and I'm a college officer. My query really connects more on the local planning query. And my query is that there's a lot of people in our area, there's a new multi-use games area going to be built. And very few people on our side, on that field, knew nothing whatsoever about it because it hadn't been put out known. To come with a new question, why wasn't it advertised more? We've been told that there was a meeting, and I don't dispute the fact, but only 30 people turned up in that meeting. They were able to express their concerns, i.e. the concerns they were expressed weren't same as my concerns, because they weren't going to be anywhere near the mother, which is going to be built on the pensioners, right on the doorstep, the pensioners estate, who have no...
Can I accept that?
They who have no... Well, let's put it this way. I've got 9 neighbours who are within 35 metres of that planet.
But the estate is not a pensioner's estate. And it's wrong to say that
it's a pensioner's estate of Bungalow. Where 9, there's the vast majority of people in the premises are pensioners. And I've asked my 9 immediate neighbours who live within 30 to 50 yards of that new plan where you're going to build a game centre where teenagers are going to be running all over. Yet none of them knew. I've been told that posters were put into the shops, posters were put out here. I've been to the 2 local shops. One on either side of our street, I've asked the proprietor, I've asked the girls working there, they had no knowledge at all of the fact that these posters were about, or this project was really going to be started. And I wish there was more people here who were residents, but I would like you to ask the residents here how many of them knew about it. Because the only people who seemed to know about it was on the Mayfield Plain side, or the East Cramlington side of the place. People on our area have not been told or informed about this proposed planning. And it starts in August, so So we've had, I only got to know about this fortnight. The consequence is, as Mr. Baker knows, I think I've already brought the subject up with you, and you've given me some information. I've also put a Freedom of Information Act request in to find out where all these forces are being posted. Why weren't people on the doorstep letter instead of leaked the drops, which nobody got at our end? So to take up your point, there's been very few communications, and it was very interesting what Mr. Burford said about the full engagement with the community. But we don't feel that we've had that. And then the problem is this project's now going to go ahead. We've had no problem. We have not been able to express our concern about the toy heap. Kids are all going to be down there. For our next years, we are going to have loads of kids running around that dolly heap and at the sports area.
That dolly heap has been running with kids the whole of my life.
Not to the extent of
the whole of my life.
When you've got... Not, I've been there 3 years. And we only have...
I've been here 66 years. And we've always played on the dolly heap.
Yes.
Always.
I'm not disputing that. But what I'm saying is, you're going to increase the number by putting this sports field right next to the dolly heap. Well, I've no doubt at all, if you're watching a football match, there'll be spectators will be on the top of this dolly heap, which is 65 paces from my goal. That's 30 yards. And every night when that park's open, or at the weekend, we are going to have to put up with the noise and all the disturbances coming. But the point I was making earlier was that there's been no communication with us regarding that plan.
I just have to beg to differ, Chair, because the consultation event in January was advertised and it was well attended.
Well,
it was focused on a relatively small area. It was about improvements to East Cramlington.
So are we involved in this conversation?
There were posters put up on lampposts along around the dolly heap, in the shops at Clifton Road, the leaflet drops along Baker Way. That area, they were undertaken by local councillors.
And that's what I said. All people that I have been dealing, Clifton Road, the shop, the two shops next to us, and you've got it on your plan that it comes from Clifton Road down to Percy Street, the shop on the corner of Percy Street, knew nothing about it.
The shop on the corner of Percy Street, you mean Klondike?
In the Klondike. where the shops are.
That is quite a distance from where you're talking about. Klondike is a fair distance.
It's about 3 minute walk from my premises.
Well, I actually live very close to where you're talking about, and I knew about it.
Well, you knew about it, because it's about the residents who don't know about it.
Can we just take
it? Yeah, I think I completely agree with what you said. I think it'd be very hard pushed to find anyone in this room that doesn't in some way have an affiliation with a political party or a position. I'm a county councillor as well.
It was passed. I'm not so uncomfortable. He said, Ken, that's okay. We're just waiting to go ahead from Bruno or the Hummus or Hammerson's, whatever, to get it done. And it was, Bruno was at the meeting that day. Is that right?
Yes,
yeah. Just like to reiterate, it obviously was quite a key concern with that, quite an important meeting with the residents and the county councils at the time. Perceived that an unusual fashion where there's land transfers and rights of access over land, these matters do take a particularly long legal process. And invariably, lawyers being lawyers, will drag it out. But as I explained only recently to Mr. Patterson, it is with the council's legal team. We are waiting for them to return that, and that's where we are. As soon as we have anything anymore, we will be dispatching it as quickly as we can, because obviously we want people to come to Manor Walk as safely as possibly as we can.
Chair.
Thank you.
It's that there's still a lot of people coming on Station Road, and if they're going to build houses on the far side of Station Road, it's going to make it a lot busier. And if that doesn't get done, I don't know what's going to happen.
Well,
I mean, you say it's got to be done. I'm saying it's 4 years, over 4 years this has been going on.
We'll have a taste of it.
Thank you.
The gentleman at the back again.
Okay, my question. Firstly, you're correct, I do have a beer in the morning, that's why I'm here. Yeah. I suppose if anybody else has a beer in the morning, you'd also be here and they are. My question is, what are the plans if you foresee development as being stated before, there's numerous housing projects going ahead. The population of this school is going to increase. What plans have you got for the management of traffic coming in and out of this school? Because the way it is now, you're heading for fatalities. It's like the Wild West on school mornings, afternoons, when there's events at the sports centre. Picking up people going from a 30 to a 40 mile an hour limit, there is chaos on the other side of the road. People parking in bus stops, on the slip road, etc.
Safety vans at the Hoyda. That is done based on information, accident data, road safety data.
But I don't know of any incidents on that.
Yeah, just let me finish. It's based on road safety data and intelligence, and it is deployed on the basis of that. Now, as a neighbourhood inspector, where we do have road safety concerns, whether it's from public meetings like this or whether it's from RTCs that happen in the area, road traffic collisions that happen, then I can feed that back, and I'll certainly feed back your concerns tonight. But actually, who decides where that goes isn't the neighbourhood police inspector, albeit I can feed residents' concerns in that. But I will certainly do that tonight, and if I can catch you afterwards, sure. I'll get some contact details from you, and I'll certainly do that.
You're most welcome.
Thank you.
Any further questions? The gentleman here, because he hasn't spoken yet, and that lady hasn't spoken, and then...
I think it's directed to the Town Council. I'm sort of informed that the Town Council hasn't made any representations for the tendering process to improve the rail links and the rail frequencies from Cramlington Station.